And we here in the West have thought of Sweden as this wonderful, kind, gentle, peaceful place, and yet these novels bring out a wholly different impression of who and what made up Sweden at the time he was writing.
Hmm. I think the Millennium books gave a balance to this dream castle.
Dream castle.
I think Sweden was too much of Disney World. Millennium gives a solid reality check. It balances out. And it's good for Sweden as well to realize that we do have problems. We have problems with corruption. We have problems with abuse of authority. We have problems with police not doing their work. And it's good for us to know that, because as a people, we don't want that. We really want justice. We really want to move forward as a country. And that is Sweden to me. And that is maybe also why Stieg's, and of course also my sadness over the state of things and desperation that nobody seemed to find any political solution to this was coming forth. It just gradually developed into more and more possibilities for company owners and board directors to take the shareholders' money or in bonuses and pension deals, as I was subjected to, and I write about that in the book as well. I cost money out of that. And this is not Sweden. People, the old-fashioned values are working hard, be honest, don't cheat, don't steal. The same values that the Swedish immigrants brought to America when they came. And I think we delivered some over a million people to you in the 19th century.
Indeed.
And they were like this. God-fearing, hard-working, loyal, absolutely dedicated to collaboration, teamwork, helping your neighbor. You didn't have to like your even less love them, that they were your neighbors and you needed their help in the future. And I think that still is the criteria for Swedish people.